Hey, Mr. Todd, are you ready to review the verse of the day?
I guess I am, Minnie Todd. What's the hurry?
I have plans to meet up with my friends once we're done.
That sounds like a lot of fun. Are you going to another Crosstown Kids dance party?
We are going dancing, but just a few of us are getting together at Addison's house.
Cool. Does it have a theme like, you know, line dancing or disco?
It's a sock hop.
Of course it is. Well, I guess we better get started so you can make your connections. Can you read today's verse for us?
I sure can. In Philippians chapter 2, verse 4, we read, "Each of you should look not only to your own interests, but also to the interests of others."
Thanks, Minnie Todd. Should we see if they know where to find it in our Bibles?
That sounds like a good idea. Where do we find Philippians in our Bibles? Is it in A, the Old Testament? Or is it in B, the New Testament? Let me see the hands again for A. And now for B. The majority says B, the New Testament. And you are correct.
Very good, everyone. I knew you'd get it right. Philippians is a letter written to the church located in the city of Philippi.
The Apostle Paul had visited the church in Philippi while he was on one of his missionary journeys. After he left there, he wrote this letter and sent it to the church to encourage them.
This letter also expresses the joy Paul felt because of everything God was accomplishing through the work of the Philippian believers. Well, with that introduction, do you have any initial thoughts on today's verse, Minnie Todd?
It certainly continues our theme from last time. In our last verse, the Apostle John was telling us how we need to love everyone. A great way to do that is to look out for the needs of other people.
Exactly. As we love others the same way that Jesus loves us, we'll start thinking about ourselves less and less. We won't be as selfish or as self-absorbed, and we'll be ready to respond when we see someone in need.
Does that mean it's wrong to look after our own interests? Should I skip dancing so I can find someone who needs help?
No, of course not. Paul isn't telling us that it's wrong to look out for our own interests, but we can't only do that. He just wants us to know that we should look out for the interests of others, too.
I get it. If we love people the way God wants us to love them, the times we should help someone else instead of helping ourselves will be pretty obvious.
That is a very good way to wrap it up, Minnie Todd.
I guess that means it's time to do the verse.
Which means it's time for everyone to stand up.
Okay, let's get up on our feet so we can do today's verse just like this.
So our verse today is Philippians 2:4, and we're going to do it just like that. Philippians 2:4 starts out, "Each of you," but instead of pointing at you, this was Paul's encouragement to us, so we want to be thinking about us as the person that needs to be doing this, so we're going to go ahead and point at ourselves. So each of you should look, and just kind of shield your eyes from the sun as you're looking off in that far distance. All right. Each of you should look not only to your own interests. Now, interest is one of those words that I think we all know what an interest is or what we find interesting. It's usually like something like a hobby or something that we love to do. Those things that we find are curious about. I think everybody knows that I am very interested in riding roller coasters, and so that's definitely one of my interests, but there's so many different things that different people can be interested in. We're going to go ahead and use the sign for interest. So what you do is you take your hand and touch your middle finger to your thumb, and then you bring it towards your chest, and you just move it out a little bit like this. So that is interests. We're going to do that again. Interests. All right, let's back it up and we'll put it all together now. Each of you should look not only to your own interests. All right, that's pretty good. Let's put it together with our reference. So it's Philippians 2:4. Each of you should look not only to your own interests. Okay, that was very good. Let's go ahead and move on and tackle the second part. All right, so it's but also. All right, and what we're going to do is we're kind of going to put one finger in the air, like we're kind of pointing, like we want to get somebody's attention. I don't know if you ever have a teacher that does that, you know, when they're about to say something really important, and they say, but I want to make sure you understand what's about to come next is really important, and they're trying to get, you know, say that for emphasis, right? And so that's what I'm thinking about, so that's what we're going to do is, but also to the interests of others. But instead of using the same sign that we used before, as we think about other people, sometimes those things that interest us are actually the things that also worry us or that we're concerned about. So we're going to go ahead and use the sign for concern. So what I want you to do is just go ahead and bring your thumbs in close to your the rest of your hand, all right? And then you hold your hands in front of you and you just kind of circle them twice like this. And that is the sign for concern, because as we think about helping others and paying attention to the interests of others, it's usually those things that have them worried or those things that they're concerned about. So we want to kind of keep that in our minds as we are learning today's verse. All right, so let's try that. But also to the interests of others. And just go ahead and point at everybody else. All right, let's back it up and go ahead and do that second phrase. But also to the interests of others. All right, I think you've got it. Let's go the whole way back to the beginning and see if we can do it from the top. So here is Philippians 2:4. Each of you should look not only to your own interests, but also to the interests of others.
That was good, but I think it will help everyone remember if we go through it again.
Good idea. Can you give us a countdown, Mini Todd?
I sure can. Here we go in 3, 2, 1.
Philippians 2:4. Each of you should look not only to your own interests, but also to the interests of others. That was really good. So what do you think, Mini Todd?
I think they'll know even better if they do it one more time.
Okay, you heard Mini Todd. Let's do this one more time. In 3, 2, 1. Philippians 2:4. Each of you should look not only to your own interests, but also to the interests of others.
All right. Great job, everyone.
I'll say, as you go through the week, remember to look for those opportunities to show God's love by looking out for someone else's needs first.
That sounds like a plan. We'll see you next time.